Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be planting hydroponic beets. They grow in all kinds of media, from rock wool, perlite, and coco coir. Today we're going to be planting them from the rock wool in the perlite and coco coir blend. They use the perlite in the mix to keep the coco coir from turning hard as a rock, so it keeps it more aeration and everything will supposed to flow easier. I've never done this before, but I've heard they can grow and there you got a fantastic healthy food. I started with a 1 1/8 inch hole 2 inches from the bottom, and there's going to be a long tube of pre-drilled small holes in there, just like the other tub that I had in the video right here. So you can check that video for how I made the buckets for the tomatoes and also the one for the tub right over here, and you can see the different methods that I've used to get things going. I used a little bit of WD-40 to slide that tube through the grommet, and everything went pretty well. So let's get started with this. So far, I drilled a 1 1/8 inch hole, and I had bought this fantastic tool right here, and if you do a counterclockwise rotation to it, it'll take the burrs off, and it's easier to put the grommet in. So let's get started with it, and I'll get back to you when it's proceeded a little further. Okay, here you can see the hole in the tank, and this is how it looks here. You can see the holes that were placed in there for drainage, because this is going to be filled up probably 60% perlite, 40% of the coco coir. And then when the beets are in there, you just hit it with a watering can, and it'll, with the fertilizer blend, of course, it'll have the same thing as all the rest of the plants I grow. It'll be with the master blend. So it'll go in here, and it'll be a little 90 degree elbow on here, and it'll probably a little piece of hose or another small piece of PVC for the drain to a small bucket. And you can have it like on top of something low, because it's going to be heavy, and you just use the watering can and feed it every day or every other day. You can do a moisture check and see how they're doing, and after you got all that growing, you're going to see some beets. So let's move on to the next phase. Okay, the way the tank is set up, this pipe here is with the weight of the material is going to push this pipe down. So in order to stop that, I cut a small piece of PVC, and I'm putting that underneath here, and I'll check it as the material gets in the tank to make sure that the PVC pipe sits right where it's supposed to sit. Okay, this is what I have so far. There's three bricks of coco coir in here and some perlite mixed in. So it's sitting, I'm in the process now of getting three more bricks, and it's going to be a six brick system, I think, after it's all done. You can see the bricks breaking up here. This is the coco coir, and it's split in half already. And this one is breaking up as well. So it'll be a few minutes, and we'll continue. Now, the coco coir is right here. It's a burpees. It's available on Amazon. You put it in a bucket of water and it breaks up in a few minutes. So that's the thing. And so, like I said, available on Amazon. And also this tool here is great for taking after you drill your holes, even for the tomato bucket system. I didn't have it for then. And for this one right now, just a counterclockwise hole, and it cleaned up all the burrs in the PVC, or the, not the PVC, but the plastic bucket and the big tub, and it was much easier to put the grommet in. They're all available on Amazon, and along with the perlite, and I'm an Amazon affiliate, and the links will be for this stuff will be in the description. So let's see how the bricks are going, and I'll get back to you in a few minutes. Okay, looks like the bucket's ready, or the tub is ready to go. I got my beets from True Leaf Market. They're the Detroit Dark Deep Beet, and I have some in the core, and I have some that I planted because I'm doing onions as well, and I thought I'd drop a couple in there. So if I have room, they'll come out of here and go in there. So it's hard to hold a camera and plant, so I'll have to just stick them in there and then get back to you and show you what I did. Okay, here's my finished product for today. I have my beets planted. And the things you see here, the little green thing sticking up, those are my short day onions. I have them from seed, the red onion and the yellow onion. All of the beet is useful. You can eat the beet greens, you can eat the beet. So the whole plant is edible. So that's it for today. Like I said, if you found this information useful, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Thank you.